Good afternoon, everybody. So we will start the webinar. So I am Vishal from NISM. On behalf of NISM, I welcome all the participants and distinguished speakers for today's webinar. So all of us are aware that COVID 2019 has created a lot of challenges for the business entities, including listed companies. And to cope up the challenges, SEBI has rightfully created an environment by providing various relaxation from various disclosure norms. So in this context, the idea of this webinar is to provide a platform for the participants to discuss issues and take guidance from the speakers. So let me just introduce you the speakers for today's webinar. So we have a speakers from SEBI exchange, stock exchanges, and market participants from the listed company side. So we have with us today, we have with us Ms. Barnali Mukherjee, the finance department of SEBI. She has been an instrument in various relaxation disclosure norms. And then we have Mr. Padeep Ramakrishnan. He's a general manager and presently associated with listing side of corporate finance department SEBI. Pradeep has been the architecture for whole framework of the relaxation and the provision SEBI has made so far. Then from the exchange side, we have Mr. Abhishkar Naik. Abhishkar is the vice president and in charge of the listing department of NSE. Then from the market participant side, we have Mrs. Savitri Parikh. She is a company secretary and compliance officer, Reliance Industries Limited. She has been in the industry for more than 25 years, and she has authored many books on the corporate law procedure. She is also a visiting faculty for IIM Calcutta over a decade. Then we have Mr. B. Ranganathan. He is a company secretary and executive vice president, Edelweiss Financial Services Limited. He has more than 29 years of experience in the corporate world, and before Edelweiss Financial Services, he had spent more than 10 years with Tata Group of Companies. Mr. Ranganathan is also a visiting faculty across various industries in India, including NISM. So with that brief introduction, now I would like to hand over to Ms. Barnali Mukherjee to give inaugural address participants, followed by Padeep Ramakrishnan will give explanation for various provisions SEBI has made for the participants.
Thank you, Vishal. Good afternoon to you all. Madam Savitri, Mr. Ranganathan, Abhishkar, and Pradeep is unfortunately he is not being able to connect through the laptop, so he will be only audible, not visible. So we are in a very critical situation, as you know, or we all know. Hope you are all keeping safe and healthy. So this COVID-19 pandemic and the consequent lockdown restrictions imposed by the national government has impacted very badly businesses not only in India but all over the world. The economic impact of the pandemic in India has largely been disruptive. The businesses all over the country are scrambling to reshape their process and make ends meet. Given the challenges that the businesses and the people are facing currently, the growth of the Indian economy is likely to remain subdued, and it will take some time to restore normalcy. The World Bank has also scaled down the projections for India's economy, forecasting 3.2% contraction and in the fiscal 2021. And this is due to the stringent lockdown restrictions put in place by the government to curb the spread of the virus, coupled with the announcement made for the economic package in mid-May. Center for Monitoring of Indian Economy, that is CMIE, has reported an unemployment rate of 25.14% in the week ended May 31st. It is believed that going forward, the situation may worsen, given that many small and medium enterprises have been winding up operations or are planning to cut down the workforce amid subdued demand. Many others might be forced to go back to the drawing board. We do not know. So, in the wake of the Everbank, in the background of the uncertainty which is observed in the recent past, owing to the concerns relating to the pandemic and the resultant fear of the economic slowdown, SEBI has introduced various regulatory measures for listed entities with a view to help them tide over the challenges. So SEBI has granted several relaxations to the listed entities, which is on temporary basis, in terms of timelines for filing of various reports disclosures under LODR. And to mention a few, because Pradeep will be taking you with the details of the relaxation, so I'll just mention a few. That extension has been given of quarterly and annual financial results till June 2020 instead of May 15 and May 31st, 2020 respectively. Then submission of consolidated financial results for the quarter ending on June 30, 2020 has been given on a voluntary basis by the listed entities, which are banks or insurance companies. And also, if they're having subsidiaries which are banking and or insurance companies. But in case of decision to publish only the standalone results and not the considered results, then such entities are required to specify the reasons for the same. Again, the date of for holding AGM by top 100 listed entities by market capitalization for the financial year 19-20 has been extended till September 30th in place of August 31st. Exemption has also been given from observing the maximum stipulated time gap between two meetings, that is of one, which is 120 days, by the board of a listed entity and its audit committee. However, but they should meet at least four times in a year, as this is stipulated in the regulation. Then extension has been given for filing of secretarial compliance report till June 30th, which was due on May 30th. Extension of filing of even corporate governance report has been given till May 15, which was due on April 15. So even the timeline for implementation of the stewardship code for all mutual funds and all categories of alternative invest funds have been extended to July 2020. These are a few I have given. You'll be having the details of the relaxation, which will come after me. So this pandemic has caused a global disruption, as you know, and has affected all nations in varying degrees. Likewise, the impact of the crisis on different companies is not uniform. So in order to provide assistance to the company to assess the impact of the crisis and disseminate the same to the investors, so as to avoid any asymmetry of information, we have issued a guideline giving advisory to the company on disclosure of material impact of COVID-19 pandemic under Regulation 33. So this also we have said that this listed entities should avoid selective disclosures related to material information, keeping in mind the principles governing the disclosures and the obligations under the listing agreement. Further, apart from this LODR relaxations, in the wake of the challenge for the Indian economy, and with a view to improve the access to funding to the corporates through capital markets when the businesses are very much under financial stress, certain relaxations have been granted. Also here, I'll just mention a few because details will be coming forward. So in the case of rights issue, reduction has been given the eligibility requirement from rupees 250 crore to rupees 100 crore. Then reduction of listing period requirement has been given from at least 3 years to 18 months only. Then relaxation of certain eligibility conditions with regard to the period of compliance with the provisions of the listing regulations, ongoing action initiated by SEBI against the issuer, promoters, directors, and settlement of violation. Then there is a reduction in the threshold for the minimum subscription, which was 90%. Now it has been reduced to 75% of the offer size. Then we have also come out with the pricing norms. Relaxation has given for the pricing norms for preferential allotment. This has been made to make fundraising easier. Also, SEBI takeover code for 2020-21 has been tweaked to allow the promoters to acquire up to 10% through preferential allotment, which is currently up to 5%. So all these measures are aimed at expanding the universe of the listed entities that are eligible for raising funds through fast-track rights issuances, reducing the time involved and providing greater flexibility in fundraising apart from easing compliance requirements. So you see, SEBI has taken several proactive measures in easing the corporate regulatory compliance burden by introducing various relaxations for listed entities. SEBI has been continuously responding to market developments through appropriate measures in consultation with various stakeholders. SEBI will continue to collaborate with the various stakeholders and support them in time of uncertainty which is resulting from the COVID-19 pandemic. So SEBI is always there for you. So with this, I would like to thank you and end my speech here. And now I think Pradeep will take up the details of the relaxations which has been granted. So you would like to know what are the details and any, I think this forum, I would like to also thank NISM for organizing this. This forum will be very good for giving any clarifications. We are there to clarify here. So thank you, all of you. And thanks. And I think Pradeep will now take it up. Yeah, thank you so much.
So till the time Pradeep joins, can we, if he has the time, can we take views from Exchange? Can we take views from Avishkar?
So first of all, I would like to take this opportunity to thank NISM, VRN sir, Vishal and his team for providing us this opportunity and platform to share the about the arrangements carried out by the Exchange to accommodate the regulatory changes and talking from the Exchange perspective, at Exchanges, the priority was always to keep the markets up and running as they are an integral component of the essential services. We as an exchange have always stood up by this belief that market stress is temporary, but resilience and trust in an orderly and highly quality market will always stand the test of time. It's almost 3 months now, and we have not only continued to remain functional, but believe that we have worked effectively and in an orderly manner. Credit to this goes to all the market participants, be it the regulator, exchanges, depositories, members, and listed entities. We, as an exchange, first cited the challenge at the beginning of March 2020 for an organization that has never done work from home. To do it was a learning curve. Actual preparations helped. By early March, a core team was set up and a plan was ready by March 12. Laptops were rented and tied into the regulatory system. And by March 17, the exchange announced this work from home for almost its 1,000 employees. 100% of the listing compliance and approvals team were enabled for work from home ahead of the March 24 announcement. At this juncture, I would just like to take a small detour and tell you why this listed entities require a special call out. For any market to function smoothly, there are 5 essential participants from the exchange perspective. Internally, it is the trading, clearing, and surveillance. And from the external side, it is the trading and the listed entity, trading members and the listed entities. We had a short notice, but were ready for it. We had to pick out the essential staff for work continuity and communicate to others that it was work from home for others. Similarly, trading members were also ready. Few members did see overzealous local authorities preventing from reaching office and all, but that too was handled. And despite the small hiccups, the 4 out of the 5 constituents, that is trading, clearing, surveillance, and members, actually continued their operations unhindered. In fact, members witnessed increase in client registration and huge spurt in trading volumes. Now, if you analyze why these 4 participants were not affected much due to lockdown, it was because they are part of the DR capabilities. DR stands for Disaster Recovery Plan. These 4 participants have been participating for years in the live trading session, which stimulates a level 4 citywide disaster in which the exchange site in Mumbai is not available. The smooth manner in which the trading took place successfully demonstrated the robustness of the DR capabilities. However, for the 5th component, the listed entities, from March onwards, SEBI started providing a host of relaxations on the due dates front, be it the filing of shareholding pattern, CG repo, financial results, etc. The interesting and heartening fact in this case was, even after so much has been said about lockdowns, etc., and they not being part of the BCP plan, 96 to 97% of the corporates have adhered to the deadline and have made the necessary filings. The percentage is equivalent to the non-COVID quarters also. A major deadline is soon approaching in the form of June 30, 2020, wherein financial results have to be submitted. Here, going by the numbers which we have currently, a bit of challenge appears, in the sense around 30 to 40% of the main board company and around only, I think so we have around 178 SME companies, out of which only 9 have till now come and filed their financial results. We are working with SEBI on this front, and at an appropriate decision shall be taken on this front at an appropriate time. Exchanges on their part have actively engaged with the corporates, and in case a genuine practical difficulty has arose, it has taken up with SEBI. SEBI too is entirely seized of this matter, without which the whole lot of relaxations would have not been possible. We as an exchange have been closely monitoring our market and the price discovery mechanism. We have put in place various measures to see that the prices are not manipulated and no one takes advantage of the market conditions. One positive outcome of not being able to hold mass events or face-to-face meetings is that it has propelled us to use digital tools. A new version of NEEPS as part of digital transformation is being planned to be released in July 2020, which will not only be faster but convenient to the users. Exchange, on the other fronts, Exchange in April 2020 also compiled and circulated a compliance calendar. Then system-generated emails are being sent for alerting about non-submissions 5 days before the due dates. Then to resolve the difficulties faced by the corporates, mobile number and email IDs of senior officials have been provided in NEEPS. The teams have been working almost on all 7 days and are available to resolve any difficulty faced at any point of time. During this particular period, adequacy and accurate news and information availability is critical from an investor perspective. Using technology, we have started identifying announcements which are inadequate and incomplete. We have started asking a whole lot of questions to corporates. You would all agree that this is good from market integrity point of view. Let me conclude by saying we understand that it is not an easy task for corporates to take care of their employees, operations and business in this challenging environment. On our part, we hope to do what it can do to support our partners through this period. Please do stay safe and well. Thanks.
Thank you very much, Avishkar, for that perspective of Exchange.